jump right into our powerhouse panel on this Thursday morning. We've got former special assistant to President Trump and commentary editor for the Washington Times, Kelly Sadler, back with us. Attorney and Republican strategist and contributor for Turning Point USA, Erin Elmore. She's got packed bookshelves behind her, as always. Erin, what happened? Are you still moving?
Yes, it's the move that will never end, so I'm sorry my bookshelves are bare, but I am here in my heart.
I'm glad you're here in spirit.
How much?
Heart.
How much are you selling those for?
Yeah, those are nice.
The bookshelves, you can have them. You must pick them up, though, Rick. You got to pick them up.
Christopher Arps is back with us. He's got a podcast, and he's a member of Project 21. And, of course, Rick Grinnell is here. Several titles around the Capitol. You go around D.C., the kitschy kind of, you know, RBG T-shirts and all the, you know, paperweights, coffee mugs. Besides Donald Trump, she's the number one seller. Kamala Harris is a close second, but it's still RBG. This is somebody that did Democrats a massive disservice by not retiring when Barack Obama was president, and the court paid for it. Erin Elmore, to you, my dear. Yes.
Am I still there? Sorry, I froze for a minute. This moving has my Wi-Fi in disarray. But having said that, you're absolutely right. When people lamented, that President Trump doesn't deserve this appointment, I said the same thing that you said. Ruth Bader Ginsburg should have retired under Obama. Was it her ego? Was it her love of the kitschy merchandise? I'm not sure. And by the way, a few things. You said a few names you have for Rick. I would like to call him future governor of California. Okay, so that's my hopeful for Rick Grinnell, my friend above me in the box. But these are the things that have importance when you are in politics. Ruth Bader Ginsburg should have retired. President Trump fairly got to pick 3 Supreme Court justices and is now shaping the future of the United States, and rightfully so. So I hope that people realize when they are in these positions, elected or appointed, it matters. And as Rick said, the state of California is run completely by Democrats, by the way. And what they could do if the recall does move forward, just have mass mail-in ballots and possibly potentially manipulate those results all the way to election day.
That's a big fear.
Yeah, Rick's here trying to recruit me as his comms guy for the for the race. I think the vice president's decision to go to the border was impacted by Donald Trump's decision to go to the border next week.
I think Donald Trump was the absolute reason why she agreed to go. They knew that the optics in Washington would be terrible if President Trump went first and Kamala was still sitting there talking about her great European world tour. So honestly, I think Trump, once again, is always leading the pack and ruling with common sense instead of ruling by polling or the news headlines.
You did a good job, Rob, of not commenting on Jen Psaki going.
What is that?
She was swatting at flies.
Is that what that
voguing
was?
Voguing.
Yeah, we saw that a day ago.
Yeah, she was voguing.
Yes. Erin, good stuff. I like that. 7:11 in the morning. She's got it. She's got it. Moving, but she's still got
Turning
it.
Turning Point always teaches you to be relevant.
That's right. Chris, it would be like me in Wake Up America. Let's welcome back our powerhouse panel. We've got attorney, Republican strategist, and contributor for Turning Point USA, Erin Elmore, with us.
We'll pick up a paycheck instead of a pistol.
Bored.
What is happening, Erin, to you on that? I mean, they also, it seems like they want to refund the police now because apparently all the money from that COVID bill can now be used to hire police officers and train them and get more cops on the street again.
I mean, first of all, I'm so happy to see David Leatherwood. Welcome to the panel. We love seeing your smiling face. But honestly, there's a famous movie that said, "Am I taking crazy pills?" And when you hear Joe Biden talk, I know that's not that professional to say, it's the professional truth. And when he speaks, it is not grounded in any sort of statistical reality. First of all, in these urban communities, these children have not been back to school. The teachers union had kept these kids out of school for over a year, and they still did not return in major cities like Philadelphia and Chicago. So this has nothing to do with school. This has nothing to do with heat. In big cities like Philadelphia, Seattle, New York, there was rioting over the winter. There was looting over the winter. The season doesn't matter. What matters is defunding the police, district attorneys who are soft on crime, mayors who are not standing up for their cities and for their people and stopping these terrible movements, whether it is to defund the police or soft on crime or no bail. We need to reform these things and take our cities back. And by the way, the data does not lie. Crime is up in every major city. And who runs every major city? Democrats. You don't see these problems in Florida, which is run by Republicans.
Well, it is fascinating. So the metric, Chris, and I know you're out there in St. Louis, and that city's been one of these, another one of these cities that it's been affected by. You know, the numbers are through the roof. We haven't seen numbers like this in 50 years in many of these cities. Florida resident officially, Ron DeSantis, is there a knock on him? Because we're so far out right now. I mean, I've been in a room where he's been interviewed. He doesn't blow me away with charisma in person. If there were a knock on him, what is it?
Well, I mean, his charisma isn't what is important about him. It's his common sense. All of these other leaders look at what's in the headlines and then decide what to do. Check the polls and they say, uh-oh, voter ID seems to be popular. Yeah, I'm for that. DeSantis just does what feels right. And by the way, his superpower is his wife, who used to be like you, Rob, a journalist on television. I think she has those great talking points. She knows exactly how to handle the media. She's the savvy one, the brains behind the operation. I also have a little nugget for you. If DeSantis decided to go to the big show and run, you know who we could slide in there who would be an awesome powerhouse for Florida? Byron Donalds. He is amazing from the Naples area. He's doing so well in the House of Representatives. I would feel that he would be another great leader for the state of Florida. We need to keep Florida free and safe. And this is my empty bookshelf because I am leaving Philadelphia. And this is my last day here in Philadelphia to become an official Florida resident.
Oh, wow.
Money goes where it's treated well. Freedom goes where it's treated well. Crime does not go where they are tough on crime. So goodbye, Philadelphia. Hello, Florida for me.
So not Andrew Gilliam.
No. I think he's otherwise occupied.
Yes, Andrew Gilliam. Boy, that was how the mighty have fallen. Former mayor of, I believe, Tallahassee. Is that right, David?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. He just, what a fall from grace. And Ron DeSantis.
And he was George Soros funded as well.
Yeah, that's correct. Ron DeSantis also never lost an election. Rick, do you have any intel on what the former president might think about some of these as the field starts to take shape, which it is? It started to take shape January 21st.
Look, my opinion is that Donald Trump is still the most popular person in the party. If he wants to run, he'll get the nomination.
An amendment from the day it was passed limited the type of people who could own a gun.
It looks confused, and it's not a good look for America. Again, the Democrats are trying to blame guns instead of what the real problem is people.
Aaron, your take on the president's address yesterday. How many criminals do you think are actually buying guns legally from legal gun dealers?
I think one minus one, which is a big fat zero. We know that guns are not the problem here. It's the crime in cities that is perpetuated by liberal district attorneys and soft on crime policies and defund the police. We know all of that. But as to the press conference, I think it's another example of Joe's severe cognitive decline. He didn't say, come on, man, you know the thing this time, but it was pretty much that. And how the left is just gaslighting the American people into thinking that he is okay, and how the mainstream media, which is just basically a Democrat super PAC, pretends that he is well, is very, very sad, because we are talking here about the leader of the free world. We need someone to appear strong, cogent, you know, really on top of their A game, and we do not have that. His points never even make sense, and we truly don't even know what he's saying.
No mention of gangs, no mention of drugs. Didn't talk about criminals. I mean, these are the bad guys. These are people, bail reform, no mention of putting these people away. Chris Arps, Kelly Sadler, Aaron Elmore, good luck with your move. To everybody at home just joining us, Aaron is on her way from Florida, from Philadelphia to Florida. That's why the
bookshelves
vacant bookshelf.
For sale.
Yes, IKEA bookshelves for sale. Just look up Aaron Elmore on Instagram. Panel, we'll see you all again very soon. Great stuff
they're
this morning.
They're not IKEA.
Yeah, they're IKEA. All right, Aaron, we'll see you soon. Coming up next on Wake Up America.